be pretty cool if you could see my computer screen too. I wonder, I'm gonna look at how you can do that. When you say you can throw more jabs than any other punch, I don't think that that's a positive thing. Like, just be, I can already, like, I already have to limit myself. I try and only throw about 60, 70 punches per round. If I'm forced to, I'll throw more. If I'm trying to go in for the kill and it's the last round, sure, I'll throw to the friggin' moon. But realistically, I'm usually shooting for 60 or 70 punches per round. Which means that if I'm only throwing 60 or 70 punches, if I can only throw that many and maintain 100%, then I need to throw the ones that do damage. Like, it would behoove me to throw all uppercuts if I could land all uppercuts, but unfortunately I can't. So the right straight is a nice, fast punch that does damage, and that's why I choose to use that as well as the hook. That last guy that we fought, and frankly, with the lag I keep complaining about. I'm gonna try and do something about that, by the way. He was a little bit too fast to use the hook effectively against very much, but usually I like to lead with the left hook, fast left hook, and progress from there. But usually do damage to the body or the face with the power right straight. But I couldn't do that. So, like I said, those are my punches. I'll throw a few jabs to get him off of me, or if he's really faster than me and I need to slow him down a little bit, I'll throw a jab and then a power punch. The last guy was just, he was just so fast. He was good. There's not much I could do about him. He did very effective damage. You noticed that I had to circle to the left constantly. If I circled to the right, he was just sidestepping and getting me with those nice punches. And I'm just not capable of that, but he was just really good at it. If I could do stuff like that, it would make the fight so difficult for people to fight me. But, like I said, I don't have that kind of skill. Everybody has their own personal skills. I'm getting good enough to start to work it in, though. It used to be that I would be like, hey, you know, I'm working on getting the basics down and learning how to really fight and understand everything about the game, which can really add a new tool that's very complicated. It's like, no thanks, but I might start working on that counter. You can throw a few counters per round and really just wreck a guy. Win rounds with counters. You don't have to spend that much energy to win the round, so the other person spends energy trying to win the round, and you end up countering them and winning anyway. So you stay at a very high strength and speed while the other guy is just doing his best to, you know, keep up, essentially. Is it funny that literally the moment that I turned on my stream, you, like, joined it, and since then, I've played several times, and, like, some people, like, come in and watch for a second, but it's, like, very few people come in. It's interesting. I wonder about how you found the stream, and why you just happened to find it so quickly. Georgia, Ohio. Alright, let's do it.
Good evening, I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the Royal London Theatre here in London, England, for tonight's main event. 10 rounds among heavyweights. This should be a really good matchup here tonight. All that energy that we saw, it almost boiled over at the weigh-in yesterday. Now it gets to explode here in the ring.
Device, a way to take that power and get it to the target.
Covers up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot. Very nice work from both men. They each got a shot in. He scores well to the belt line again. And coming upon the halfway mark of this 3-minute round. Able to block that away. It was targeted for his head. Boxing 101. Jab followed by the straight. Takes one but gets one. Good work by Lewis. Right from the start in this fight, he's committed to the body shots.
Well, that's the time to go there right at the beginning, because body work pays off for you later in the fight. No sense in wasting time. Get right to it.
Count down the final moments of this round.
Watch the hook!
And we come to the end of round number one. Lewis is back in his corner now, probably reflecting on what was a very solid round. Now, he didn't overwhelm his guy with a quantity of punches, but he was so effective with what he did for him.
Yeah, you're right. You know, a lot of times people think that the muscles that count the most in any sport, especially in this sport, such a difficult sport, is, you know, the biceps or physical things that you see, you know, the chest and back. You know, this guy's got the strong muscle up top. You know, over his shoulders, in between his shoulders, his brain. And that's why he's picking the spot so well. That muscle is serving him to win this fight.
Left hook to the body, then he comes back with the right hand. Digs in with a good solid uppercut after taking a shot. Section as the target with the combination punching. A little head hunting with the right. A stinging uppercut by Lewis.
Yeah! Good work!
Halfway through round number two. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Lewis is not just floating up. He's landing combination punches like he did right there. what he does when he's at his very best. Way to block there. Left hook to the body, right hand, nicely done. Last 10 seconds.
All right, come on, let's finish this. Keep going, just keep.
And round number 3 is underway. Get in! That's a forceful 2-punch combo by Magnifico. Up top with the right hand. Punching is working well here. Lion's scoring with that right hand.
Teddy, I don't think he's got visions of sticking around too long. He's laying the power punches early.
Yeah, he wants to make it a quick night's work.
Halfway through this round, the Lion's putting his punches together now. That's a nice combination. A target on his head, and he places the hook right on it. Targeting upstairs. Good effective work with that straight right hand.
They couldn't keep their arms up by the time they got to the 8th, 9th, 10th round. That's kind of the way this guy fights.
Do you see any way in which he can take his opponent's aggression and turn it against him?
Yeah, the perfect way. I mean, boxing 101, counterpunching. You got a guy coming at you, no better way than to change his mind. Make him miss, make him pay.
Seconds to go in round number 4. The combination punching now scoring well by Lewis. Lewis's work in training camp is now paying off. Do you see the accuracy and the effectiveness with that
nice
combination?
Work. Nice work!
Scored well with that right hand to the body. Fourth round now in his last 10 seconds. A great combination there.
Can he make predictions in boxing?
Well, fine.
A
listen to me.
Task, but I'll
we gotta do a little
right
more. We have to pull ahead of this round, okay?
Round.
You need more than one punch
this fight
now.
Is gonna be
more
a
than one.
Brutal display as long as
don't
the
fight his fight. Jab and move. Jab and move.
Contact. Nobody's trying to hit singles or doubles. You know they're all going for the fence.
Unable to land that body shot. The Lion's taken a lot of punishment with the right hand. Teddy, you said many times, it's where you put your own head when you get hit by those right hands.
Well, one place I can tell you where not to put it, in the middle.
Finish with the hook!
They need to move it to the left, outside that right hand.
Final 10 seconds of the sixth round. Magnifico is so dangerous with that accuracy. A two-punch combination landed. Well, this round comes to an end. Joe and Teddy with your ringside.
This is one of those fights that it just feels like to me where it's going to be tough to really score. I mean, it's been a close fight.
Yeah, it's a hard fight to score because you have one guy maybe a little busier, but the other guy makes up for it because he's a little heavier. A little heavier with those blows. So it's a matter of maybe the taste of the judges, what they prefer.
Lion's right hand scores well that time.
He's that hand.
Magnifico's at his best. When the combinations are landing, he scored well there with that combo. Little head knocking with that right hand. Lion's doing well here with that two-punch combination. By Magnifico. Nice defense. Good block by Lewis. Sharp and accurate 1-2 by Magnifico. Magnifico is on the bad end of a very impressive hook up top. Hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination. Lewis is showing you what it takes to be the best in this business. Good, crisp combos. Start to change. I think we've seen it in these past few rounds leading up to this eighth round. Your scorecard now shows a slight margin in his favor.
Yeah, he's like that kid in the classroom, you know. All of a sudden he stands up. He says, hey, gets the teacher's attention, and he says, hey, I want to be heard.
Push it.
Oh, he's been heard.
I want to be counted.
Lewis is tagged. And now you can see him doing some fine work here on the outside of his opponent.
You know, you already know he's going to win on the inside. That's his play. Now he's controlling things outside where it's not supposed to be his play.
Now he's putting his punches together, the combination upstairs. The halfway point of round number eight. Takes one to give one. He comes back with a right hand. Nicely timed 1-2. He took a shot, but he gets one of his own. A left hand scores. One of the fastest punches in the game. You see how he just turns over that hook? He brings it right back. Big shot upstairs. The Lion's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. Well-placed overhand right. Magnifico's on the receiving end of a hook. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by the Lion. Oh, good exchange there. Well-placed counter punch by Magnifico.
Keep doing what you're doing. Keep the jab pumping and throw the lead right hand, all right? You are winning this fight. Don't let him breathe. He's hurt. Get him in this round.
Good action here tonight. Both guys bringing their best. And both guys meeting each other, stride for stride, punch for punch. Tough fight to score here as we're back underway. able to get away from that headshot with the block. Southpaw right jab, then the left hand. The Lions doing a really nice job here. I mean, putting his punches together. This is what you're supposed to look like as an offensive fighter.
Yes, it is, especially when you have a guy in front of you putting the inbox on. You know, you cover up the way that his opponent is, you're supposed to put them together. One or two are going to be blocked, but when you put them together like that, they're going to get through.
He missed with that headshot. Lions landed a good, solid combination. Blocking away his opponent's effort. Good combination to the body. Working his way on the outside. Did you see that? Hits him right on the spot. Lewis is still in a tough spot here. Don't get fooled just thinking he beat the count and everything's fine.
And I'm not so sure that he can grab. So what you got to do now, if you're a trainer, the way you taught him in the gym is, you don't want to go grab him because you might lose yourself up. Move your head when he comes to you, then you grab him.
Sending shots to the midsection.
Favorite.